Hi kids, how are you? Yeah, today we are going to learn a new chapter, data handling. You have already heard this word, correct? It's not new for you. You have done this in 7th standard. Yeah, actually all are well versed with data handling. In 7th standard, which were things we have learned, if you remember, what was data handling? It is collection, organizing and representation, correct? It's like we collect something or we represent something and organize it in a proper manner so that we can interpret, we can get information out of it. So in simple words, data is nothing but collection of information. Yeah. Now for example, I can give for data handling, it's like a teacher writing down the names of the students and their scores. Correct? Yeah. Then if you remember, in 7th standard, you have done many data handling, like there are types of data handling which you have done, like pictograph, bar diagram. Do you remember bar graphs? Correct. So in this chapter also, we'll start with again pictograph, just a revision of 7th standard, then a bar graph, then there is double bar graph, histogram, pie chart and many others. Okay. So these all we are going to cover in this chapter. The first we come with pictograph. Anyone remembers what is a pictograph? Okay. It is a graph form given with the help of diagram, with the help of pictures. I will just show you an example, then I'll explain it. Yeah kids, can you see this picture? This is an example of pictogram. Pictogram helps us how? We just have to see the pictures and we can get information. We can read what actually they want to say. Now can you see the first column? The column itself, seeing, you can see it is the name of the fruits written over there. The second column, the title head is given, number of students. Over here, so what is the thing? It is a survey done of the students, which students see, or it is a survey done about which fruits are eaten by, are liked more by the kids. Okay, so now, and can you see in the end the column where it is written mango is equal to 2, apple is equal to 2, banana is equal to 2, oranges is equal to 2. This means they are specifying one orange, one banana, one mango and one apple, means two. So for example, if I say, can you see fruits, mangoes, first column, how many mangoes are drawn? Number of mangoes, you can see picture, 3. One mango is 2, so 3 mangoes means how many, actually how many mangoes are there? 6. Very good. So number of students who eat from this column, we can check out mangoes eaten by student is 6. The quantity is 6. Now how can we read about apples? Can you count, kiddos, how many apples are there? Total there are 10 apples. How many are there? 10 apples are there. Now again see in the column, 10 apples, it's written 1 apple is equal to 2. So 10 apple will be how much? If 1 apple means 2, you have to count 1 apple means 2. So 10 apples will be 20. Very good. Correct. So number of students eating apples are how many? 20. 20 students are there. Such who eats apples. 6 students are such who eat mangoes. Similarly about bananas. How many bananas are given? 8 bananas are given. And in the bracket it is specified 1 banana means 2. So if 8 bananas is there, total how many students it stands for? Yeah. stands for 16. Very good. Yeah. So we can say 16 kids eat bananas. Clear? And similarly about we can read or we can get information about the oranges also. There are 5 oranges given. Same way. 1 orange is equal to 2 students. So how many students eating oranges? It is 10 students. Clear? So just looking at the pictures, we can get information. This is called a pictograph. Clear, kids, all of you? Okay. Now in the group I have given homework. Try to do the sums. I have already explained in the classroom also many sums. Fine. So try it. Yeah. Bye-bye. See you.